How long does food really last? You ever buy something and have to throw it away by its expiration date, even though it looks perfectly good? Well, it probably was still totally fine to eat. You threw it away because of one of the biggest lies ever told in the food industry. A lie that's had you wasting food and money all this time. And today, I'm gonna uncover it all. Hello, Internet! Welcome to Food Theory, the show that always stays fresh. It'll happen to all of us at some point. You'll go to the fridge to cook something and the expiration date on the packaging says that the food just expired. But you look at it and it looks no different than it did the day before when it was supposedly in date. So what do you do? Do you throw it out and rush to the supermarket to buy a brand new one or just risk eating expired food? I mean, Steph did it in the last Christmas tree episode when she chugged expired milk and she's, well, actually I haven't seen her lately. We should probably double check and make sure she's alive. Point is, the expiration dates you see on everything you buy are unreliable, inaccurate, and overall just sus. It seems like an odd choice to slap an expiration date onto everything in the grocery store, especially because it's not even a law. In fact, the only thing that legally has to have an expiration date is baby formula, which definitely makes sense, but it begs a question as to why the practice of putting a date onto foods is so common and so inaccurate. And that's where I come in. Because even if we've been lied to all these years, you, dear theorists, shouldn't have to suffer the consequences. So even though expiration dates are a complete lie, by the end of this episode, you'll have everything you need to know to never throw away another carton of milk ever again, and save yourself some cash in the process. One thing to cover right off the bat here is that not all food expires. Honey, vinegar, dried beans, and soy sauce are just some of the things that'll last indefinitely if they're stored correctly or if they're sealed. So there you have it. When the apocalypse comes, stock up on all those things and you'll expire before they ever do. Episode done. Bon appetit. Roll credits. Or if you're not a mad lad who will happily survive on just that really weird diet, let's look at what happens to all the other foods when they quote unquote expire. In most foods, the cells and organisms within them break down and change over time. This can cause harmful bacteria to grow, which can lead to problems if you eat it. This is why it's important to store the food correctly and not eat it if things start growing on it that shouldn't be. The thing about this is it's not unnoticeable to the average person when a food item actually expires. Food has a way of telling us that it's gone bad. The food will either taste bad or start to smell rancid. I don't know if you've opened up a packet of spoiled raw chicken, but oh my gosh, it smells like prim cake looks. Thing is, there's a lot of room for error since there's a bit of time before it goes full on smell-o-vision on you where you still shouldn't eat it. There are also foods marked as non-perishable, and as the name suggests, they don't turn rotten or smell rancid after a certain time, but they do still expire in a sense. The other effect of food going past its use-by date is that the nutritional value becomes lost and the quality of the item deteriorates. Items like spices may technically be non-perishable, with ground spices claiming to last 2 to 3 years, but they can gradually stop being as spicy after that time. Simply put, the product quality decreases. Now, you may have noticed that I've been using different phrases for the general idea of expiration, and you may have come across them yourself while shopping. There's sell-by, use-by, best-if-used-by, and freeze-by, and they all indicate different things. Sell-by tells the store how long they can display the product on their shelf. It's mostly for inventory management on their part. Use-by is the last recommended date for the highest quality of whatever the food is. Best-if-used-by just indicates when a product will taste the best, and freeze-by tells you when it should be frozen to keep it at that peak quality and flavor. None of these are any indicator of safety or actual expiration. The terms refer only to the quality of the food. In fact, the USDA nor the FDA require expiration dates except for on drugs and baby formula, like I mentioned before. And even then, it's not a matter of if they're safe past that date, it's to indicate that they may not work or provide what they need to after that day. This is important because you need to know if a drug is still going to work as promised or if the formula will provide the nutrients the little one needs. But when it comes to food, what this means is the dates you have on them only indicate how long the food will remain at its intended quality. Not that the food will now poison you if you eat it a day after the label date. What's even crazier about this is that there's no set standard for how to label this stuff. Throughout all my research, I couldn't find anything. No industry or government metric, no agreed upon equation between industries for how to label food. Each individual company is basically picking their own numbers, and more often than not, but rounding it way down from the actual date, the food will go rotten or spoil. So if these dates are merely from a quality perspective rather than safety, why do we have them? What's the point? Well, this wasn't always the case. People were able to figure out what to eat and what not to eat way before expiration dates. Farmers knew what was ripe or not when picking crops and bringing them to market, and sellers were able to eyeball their own food and judge for themselves whether it had gone bad. But during the Industrial Revolution, rail transport and machinery allowed factories to mass produce canned goods, where suddenly you had no way of knowing until you opened the can. Not a game you want to play when you and your hangry kids are clamoring for dinner. And the worst part of it was the factories making the food had zero health and safety regulations, so people didn't know if the food even looked good, appetizing, or was even sanitary to eat until they opened it up. This is where the FDA came to help. Not to introduce expiration dates, which didn't come until the 70s in the US, but to create a standard practice for producing food in a sanitary and consistent way across all food factories. What's crazy is that the government was only made aware of unsanitary conditions because of a novel by Upton Sinclair called The Jungle. The novel was set in horrifyingly unsanitary meat factories, but the big twist was that it wasn't all fiction. According to Sinclair, these stories were inspired by real factories in Chicago. And when the government caught wind of this, they decided to inspect it for themselves, only to realize that, oh dang, it was even worse in real life. Full on horror movie jump scare moment. To stop these unsanitary and unregulated kinds of practices from happening again, the government founded the FDA to keep these factories sanitary, but also to keep the production of food and food packaging consistent across the board so customers wouldn't have to do so much guesswork with the quality of food inside their cans. But there were still no expiration dates placed on products at this point. And like I mentioned, it's still not a requirement by the FDA to this day. The idea of putting a sell-by date on perishable items was actually invented by the British retail and department store company Marks & Spencer, or M&S as Tom told me to call it. M&S first used these dates in their storerooms in the 50s, but put them on the shelves in 1972 when they completely overhauled their line of cakes. It was so successful, it caught on and everyone started copying it. And M&S is still bragging about it in their commercials.
They brought in sell-by dates on perishables. Cheeky.
I honestly don't think my eyes can roll further back into my skull. To be fair, this was done as an honest attempt to let people know when food would go bad, but it also wasn't enough. People at the time didn't care as much about food going bad. They wanted food to have a longer shelf life and cost less. After World War II, countries like the United States and the United Kingdom weren't doing the best economically, in part because of the recovery from the war, but also because of the largest generation in a century. The one that I and other fellow kids call Boomers. With this increase in the financial state of the country, people started demanding cheaper food. And it was here that the production of overprocessed, overpasteurized, sterilized, and artificial food began. It sure tasted like the real thing, but lasted way longer and cost way less to produce. So if you're wondering why your box of Fruit Loops has several months left on its use-by date, it's because it's been overprocessed to cut costs and only use small amounts of the actual ingredients. These kinds of items are like our spices. They're not gonna go rotten, but they are likely to lose their quality and flavor after the date printed on the can or box. No one wants stale, chewy cereal, after all. This, again, was done in an honest attempt to help the general public be able to afford food in financially difficult times, and let them last longer for our convenience. But, soon enough, as these things often go, other companies looked at this concept, and what they saw were dollar signs. In the 90s, our good old friend Pepsi began putting a sign on every one of their cans that read, "For best taste, drink by date on bottom." This was part of a new marketing campaign where Pepsi declared that the cans tasted at the absolute peak of freshness up until that day. Before this, people weren't exactly worried about soda going stale, but now people wanted to make sure they were drinking it before that date. This date, by the way, had nothing to do with the drink going bad, just that the quality of the drink may not be as good as it could be. Pepsi used these dates as a marketing strategy. Other companies saw this tactic and wanted it for themselves, and eventually this became the norm for all products. Even products that would definitely last longer than the use-by date, like cereals and chips. What it did was make sure customers were consuming the products quickly before it was supposedly too late and had to throw them out. It's all a marketing strategy to get you to buy more of a product, even if it means throwing away a perfectly good box of cookies just because they're past the use-by date. All that means for the companies is you continue to buy their product and they never get stuck with a bad reputation of giving you a stale cookie. As long as you buy the product, they don't care what you do with it. So, okay. Sure, Sure, these use-by dates are mostly arbitrary. They don't account for consumer safety, but instead ensure that you get the most freshness and best taste. But is that a problem? You're getting a better product if you follow the dates, after all. But there's a bigger issue at play here with the way we follow these guidelines. Throwing away food after the alleged expiration date is creating a lot of food waste. If you're throwing away expired food and then just buying more, the company still benefits. They still get the sales. At the end of the day, we're the ones paying for it. Literally. Every year, the average American family throws out between $1,300 and $2,200 worth of food. And 40% of food produced in America ends up in landfills. That's every year. Although some of this is from supermarkets throwing away food that isn't bought due to some cosmetic reason, like Abraham Lincoln-shaped carrots that no one will buy or something, it's estimated that 9 out of 10 Americans are wasting edible food because of this confusion on expiration dates. We're throwing away perfectly good food, and we know by now that these dates mean nothing to the safety of the product itself. So how can we stop this food waste crisis? How can we do our part to reduce the amount of food being wasted? Well, first of all, don't just go off the date printed on the packet. And let me be clear, I'm no doctor. I am not saying eat food that's gone bad. All I'm saying is that if your food is bad to eat, you'll probably know about it. Bad smells, mold growing on it, vegetables looking rotten. Like I said, food does its best to tell us if it's safe to eat. If your food is past the use-by date, don't immediately throw it out. Take a closer look at these factors that clearly indicate that it's gone bad, not just the printed date on there. It's not that the dates these companies use are bad, just misleading. They're not always based on science, and more often than not are rounded way down to be extra careful their products don't turn. Another thing you can do, which sounds counterintuitive, is buy near expiration date food if you're able to, because most of the food waste comes from supermarkets tossing food that's past the expiration date. A date, mind you, that they themselves set. Again, I'm not telling you to eat rotten food, but by knowing what shelf life different products actually have, we can use our own knowledge and senses to determine if the food is safe. For example, an unopened container of milk from a supermarket can stay good for up to 5 to 7 days past the listed date in the refrigerator. Similar for meat and poultry, with chicken lasting around 1 to 2 days, ground beef 3 to 5 days, and eggs 3 to 5 weeks past the date. There are lots of guides online for how long produce and all these other foods stay good when stored correctly. When it comes to foods that don't spoil as easily, like canned foods or non-perishable things like chips, you don't have to worry about the date so much. But remember that the longer you wait past that day, the less nutritious or flavorful they'll become. And here's the thing, expiration dates, they might be going bye-bye altogether. Just like they started the whole thing, Marks and Sparks, which is a way better name than M&S, might be ending it all too. Since 2022, they've removed dates from 85% of their fruits and vegetables, and other major grocery stores in the UK have decided to follow suit. The question remains whether the US will do the same, especially since the fear of being sued by customers who might eat rotten food looms over the company. But history might repeat itself, especially if companies find a way to market it and spin it in their favor. So now you know why you shouldn't blindly trust the expiration dates. It's all a marketing ploy to get you to waste more food and money so that companies can keep their fresh reputations and keep you coming back for more. And if you're rummaging through your fridge to see what you can cook for dinner tonight, don't worry about the pesky dates and just rely on your senses. If foods smell off, feel off, or look off, they most definitely are. And if there's any doubt, take a small bite or swig, and if it doesn't taste like it should, spit it out and throw it out. When it comes to your proteins, if you're afraid they'll spoil before you can get to them, you can always freeze them to help them last way longer than any date will ever say. And the cold will keep bad bacteria from growing and spoiling them. So don't let big food fool you. If you want to waste less and save more, you don't need a silly sticker to tell you when it's not safe to eat something you bought. Just use your senses and make sure you're storing your food correctly. While expiration dates may lie, food does not. But hey, that's just a theory. A food theory. Bon appetit. If you like this episode and want to see how else you've been lied to, click the link on the screen now to watch how supermarkets have been scamming you. And as always, I'll see you next week.